Just before midnight on July 15th, a major magnitude 7.2 earthquake occurred offshore of a section of Alaska in the eastern Aleutian island chain. This quake was not caused by a so-called megathrust quake related to two tectonic plates colliding and then snapping back. Rather, a large reverse fault on the subducting slab slipped and moved by several meters, generating widespread ground movement. This ground movement was experienced across an area the size of Wisconsin, ranging from Unalaska in the southwest to Pilot Point in the northeast, awakening many. While this quake had the potential to be devastating, the closest populated place, aka Sand Point, Alaska, only experienced shaking equivalent to the simulation shown on screen. While this did not generate a damaging tsunami due in part to the quake's depth, it might have caused a change in activity at the Shishaldin volcano on the adjacent Unimak Island. As, only an hour after the large magnitude earthquake, Shishaldin produced a major eruption, sending a sustained plume of ash to a height of 16,000 feet, which then formed an ash cloud 125 kilometers in length. This begs the question, did the earthquake cause the sustained ash plume, or would it have erupted at the same time anyways without the quake? The short answer, per the Alaska Volcano Observatory, is that the two events are not related and one did not cause the other. However, it is surprisingly plausible that the magnitude 7.2 might have caused Shishaldin's eruption to temporarily intensify, in my opinion. At some Indonesian volcanoes, it is generally accepted that an earthquake which generates shaking of MMI 5 or higher can, while highly unlikely, trigger a volcanic eruption at a volcano already primed to erupt. Shishaldin experienced shaking equivalent to an MMI of 4, which, although a bit low, means the quake technically could have caused a temporary increase in eruptive intensity, as it is fairly close to the aforementioned threshold. And, after the sustained volcanic explosions ended, Shishaldin experienced a drop in eruptive activity for the next 24 hours. Shishaldin is rightfully considered to be one of the most, if not the most, symmetrical volcano in Alaska. Covered by glaciers and always having a white summit, it might come as a surprise that it is also one of the state's most active volcanoes, with more than 20 historic eruptions. Shishaldin's latest eruption began without much fanfare on July 11, 2023, when satellites detected strong heat signatures originating from its summit region. A webcam then picked up a faint orange glow, which was later confirmed to be fresh lava emitted from a 15-foot-high spatter cone. This eruption remained almost completely effusive until a significant explosion occurred at 1:09 a.m. local time on July 15th, sending a plume of ash to a height of 40,000 feet. Weaker explosions subsequently continued before becoming intermittent, then the magnitude 7.2 earthquake struck. And again, on July 18th, Shishaldin produced its third major eruption in its current eruptive sequence, where, after a continuous increase in volcanic tremor in the preceding 12 hours, a sustained 30,000-foot-high plume was generated. More explosions like this have the potential to disrupt some regional air traffic, primarily in the eastern Aleutian Islands region. All these explosions have melted snow to generate lahars on the flanks of the volcano and created 1-mile-long pyroclastic flows, I would only estimate its current eruption to represent a VEI 3 on the 0-9 volcanic explosivity index. The last week seemingly represents the volcano's most powerful eruption since 1999. Although we do not know how long this volcano will erupt for, some of Shishaldin's eruptions have continued for more than 6 months. For now, more small-volume explosions with infrequent large volcanic explosions are to be expected while Shishaldin is erupting. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.